We are still looking at the Caja file manager, and looking at my downloads folder, you'll notice that I no longer have any emblems or notes added to my files. I removed all the emblems and notes because while testing the different functionality for this video, my test machine lost some Caja functionality. Here's a picture of my test machine. You can see that we lost the sidebar over here, and we also lost the search bar right up here. But we're also missing Go and Bookmarks. And on the View dropdown, we're missing the second section that was here. I checked the internet, but I was unable to find a fix for this problem. I did find some posts telling me that I should reinstall the Mate Core apps. I tried that, but it didn't work. If this happens to you, you might want to consider downloading the Dolphin file manager. It's available in the software manager. Now I'll move on with the video. Going into Edit, down at the bottom we've got this Backgrounds and Emblems. To change the background of the view pane, I can click on Colors and change the color. And we see it's not working that well. This could be the issue that caused me to lose my sidebar. If I go into Documents, now if I try the color, the mango works, the mint green, the blue. Going into Patterns, I can make a pattern background. And to remove this and go back to no background, we need to click on the reset and drag that in. Releasing it changes it back to the white background. We also have the emblems on here. Clicking that, these work the same as the sidebar. You drag it in and it's there. Drag it in again and it's gone. Down at the bottom, we've got the eraser. We also can add in a new emblem. Clicking that shows me the Create a New Emblem dialog box, and clicking the image allows me to choose a new image. Going into Pictures, I will take this Cycle BMP. It's asking for a keyword. I'll call it Cycle. Clicking OK, and we should see it in here. And there it is. I can add this to a folder or a file. And adding it again removes it. And to remove my new emblem, I'll click on Remove an Emblem, and then click on the cycle, and it's gone. Now I want to review some of the basic features that we should already know, but sometimes forget about. For instance, if I right-click here, I can open up a new tab. And inside here has the Needs Attention folder. I don't have any files in it, but if I did, we would see them here. I do want to point out this is different than the View Extra pane, which gives us a whole separate pane. This is just a separate tab in the same window pane. I'll turn this off and close this tab. Going back into the Downloads, we can select a group of files by clicking on one, and if I hold down Shift, it selects all the files in between those two. Clicking off that resets it, or I can click and hold down Control and select just a few files. To move them to another file or to the desktop, I would click and drag, and there they are on the desktop. I'll move them back in. And if I want to make a copy of them, I will hold down Control, clicking on any one of these that is selected, and move it out to my other window, or in this case, the desktop. And now we've got a copy made. I'm going to select these again and hold down Shift Delete so they are permanently deleted. And for these three selected, now what I'm going to do with them is I'm going to right-click and I want to send them to a single compressed folder or a zip file. It's asking me the file name I want to give it, and its default is downloads. I will call this tfcg files. Now the default is a .tar.gz file, but we can change that. We can make this a 7-zip or just a regular .zip, and that's what I'm going to choose. Clicking this other options, I can make this zipped file password protected. I'm not going to do that now. And this last part, location, asks me where do I want to put my new zipped file. I will add this to the desktop. Clicking create. There we see our new zipped file. I'll right click on this. I can unzip this file using the archive manager. I can extract to another location, or just extract here, which will unzip the file right to the desktop. And here's my new file and my three files in the new unzip folder. I no longer need these. I will select, shift, delete, and delete these permanently. Once again, we're at a good breaking point. I'll stop here, and in the next video, we're going to look at the location bar and the search tool. If you like these videos, please tell a friend